Originally, when my father came to this empty plot of land, he was trying to figure out what kind of a place he can start to experiment and build structures that would help humanity and nature. They had no money or anything like that, so they said, what can we do that would be really inexpensive? Well, let's dig a hole.
My dad was so passionate about helping people, and he believed that architecture was most meaningful if people were able to build themselves their own home with nothing but the earth under their feet. This was his quest, this was his life's work that he spent every day out here in the desert, and sometimes people thought, you know, what's this crazy man doing?
Nader Khalili, our founder, an Iranian-American architect, got a lot of his inspiration from classical Persian poetry, and especially the mystic poet Rumi, who says, earth turns to gold in the hands of the wise, and the timeless four elements of earth, air, water, fire. And we use the four elements really in all of our practices. Earth is our primary material, and varying the water content, we could get earth to behave in a lot of different ways. Fire can be seen as the sun. We position our building so the sun helps heat it when we need heat, and it also shades itself. And of course, air leads to the drying of the building. In a nutshell, Nader would tell people to dig your pool and build your house. And we just teach people the basic skills of how to transform that earth from under your feet to over your head.
Originally, when my father first came here, this desert was completely empty. Then when the housing boom happened, we became surrounded by these cookie-cutter homes.
We get a lot of Star Wars. It looks like Tatooine, or it looks like Hobbit houses. People ask, oh, are you a commune? Like, well, not really. We have an on-site residency program, but we're not a commune. You know, they're like, are you a cult? We're like, well, we're very passionate about what we do, but we're not a cult.
My father was a traditional architect and urban developer building skyscrapers, but he was very unhappy. So he left that work because he realized that it wasn't serving humanity or the earth.
We build arches, we build circles, we build domes, we build vaults, and these are all based on the same cooperative relationship with gravity, where gravity is not slowly pulling your building apart, but it's consistently pulling your building together over time.
It's actually amazingly flexible. So every time we go to another country to design something there, we always take into consideration local traditions, different kinds of waterproofing or plastering, so that we can accommodate the needs of the people who are going to live in the homes.
We've taken these structures and taught a lot of people, and they've been built all over the world, from Africa to Europe to Asia, dealing with humanitarian crisis and personal housing.
Our site in San Bernardino here at CalEarth, it's our mothership, it's our playground, it's where we get to experiment, and we don't know what it is that we're gonna find later with these exciting experiments that we're doing today. Nader firmly believed and would teach his students that hands are just as much tools for receiving information as our eyes or ears or noses, and the only way they start working is by putting them in the earth. We can take someone who might not even be comfortable changing a light bulb in their own house, but after 6 days of our intensive workshop, they can go somewhere and get some unskilled laborers and guide them together into building a safe shelter. Hello, everyone. Welcome to CalEarth. Thank you so much for joining us out here.
We're very open to the community, and we're all about community. So we have an open house every month for people to come and visit and tell them all about it.
We have people who come locally and they bring their friends and their neighbors to show them, and they see what we've been able to do with just the earth and some sandbags and barbed wire. They're truly, truly amazed at the possibilities. While my father's initial focus was always on building for the poor, this house here that we're in right now is called Earth One, and it's the kind of house that fulfills that suburban dream. Three-bedroom house with a two-car garage and a fireplace and everything like that. Significantly less expensive than building a traditional structure. Also doesn't lead to deforestation. And literally, you're going to build your house from what's underneath your feet.
The building envelope is more sustainable. It will cost you less to heat and cool and maintain over its lifetime.
We've been able to create plans that have passed a rigorous test by the Building Department of California to allow these structures to become mainstream and available to everybody.
Everyone deserves to have a shelter over their head. They have the earth around them and they have the labor around them. They just don't have that information to get the earth to provide shelter for them. Every day we fire up the mixer and shovel some earth and just slowly pursuing our quest, one shovel at a time,